I do apologize if I sound funny in this video. I am very sick, but I hope you enjoy it. One of the things that I wish I knew when I first started DayZ modding, or before I even began, was how DayZ uses the inheritance system of classes. The inheritance system of classes is a very simple concept. It pretty much states that a class can have children, and the children of that class inherit its variables, floats, and strings, as well as integers. So, for instance, if you had the class base inventory base, and it had scope, and display name, and all these other variables, strings, bools, and ints, you could have a class inherit off of that. So for a good example of this is, I have my example duct tape inheriting off of inventory base. The two dots resemble that. Now in this thing, I am changing the display name of the example duct tape from the inventory base. Now the inventory base's display name is test. So when I put in my own display name here, and I put in the string variable, I can change it to example duct tape. I could also change any of these other variables based on the thing. Now, with that basic understanding of how the inheritances work, I can then have it so my example duct tape inherits off of the example duct tape we have above. Now, if you notice in the example duct tape underscore two, it doesn't have all of the same variables that example underscore duct tape has, and example underscore duct tape didn't have all the variables of inventory base has. Well, that's because it inherits the values automatically, and they do not need to be stated unless you are changing them. So for example, in example underscore duct tape underscore two, I changed the scope remained the same, but I changed the display name, I changed the weight, and I changed the item's inventory size, as you can see here. This is a very interesting and basic concept of inheritance. So the inventory base is the original parent, the example duct tape is the child, and then the example duct tape 2 is the grandchild of the inventory base. To show you an easier situation, so here we are, and we have ourselves, inventory base is the parent or the original creator, and then example duct tape base is the child, and then example duct tape 2 is the other child. So this is the grandparent, this is the parent, and then this is the grandchild, or child of the parent of this parent. Very easy to understand if you think of it as lineage and stuff. So example two can pull all of the same inventory bases from inventory, and example duct tape can as well, and they could have offshoots or whatever else. This is really great when you're first starting off and getting your hands into making classes, because this is very useful for making core classes. So you can take the original notepad and create more clean classes like this without having to do this. Now, for example, we could also take a look at how retexturing clothing classes work. So if we were to go down here, you can see that the armband color base inherits off of clothing. So we define the clothing, right? Now we have our hidden selections, camo ground, and all of these. Now, if we were to make a different colored armband off that armband color base, we would have our armband white inherit off the armband color base. And you can see here that we have a new selection that we didn't have in armband. Well, that selection already exists inside of the inheritance clothing comes away from. So what that does is, instead of us having all of this stuff that we don't need, including the hidden selections, all we have to do now is change these things to make it apply to every one of these selections from the class that it inherits from. Again, we are inheriting off an armband color base. And this could be repeated with yellow or orange. And it's very, very useful and helpful for understanding how retextures work. And that is the basics of a CPP inheritance system. So now we're going to be talking about how inheritance works with scripts and how the scripts actually function overall. Now, we're not going to be covering how scripts function, but rather how inheritance works with those scripts. So this example is us looking at the item base.c, as you can see way up here. Now, the item base.c pretty much states that this is the class for the item base. Now, this is the name of the file. However, at the very top of this, you would see the class item base. and it extends off of inventory super, I believe. So here we have our void set actions, and then we have in all of these different add actions. Now, as you can see, it says void set actions, and it doesn't say anything extra. So if we were to, let's say, change how this set actions was used in later on, again, this is the parent, and then it has children. So one of the children is the duct tape. Duct tape is a child of itemace, as you can see here. Here's itemace, and here is the inheritance thing, the two dots, right? Now, in class duct tape, we can see here, we have a override void set actions, and then we have a super. The super on the top of the set things means that anything below the super will be loaded after anything above before it. So when you load up your mod and you have a super, it will load everything that you put below it, even with other mods being loaded. Now, as you can see here, they say they have add repair tent, repair shelter, restrain target, and restrain self, but that wasn't in the original set actions. So that means that they're adding these actions on top of these actions, which is very nice. So let's go back to the duct tape. Well, let's say we wanted to add in our own actions. So we can copy and paste into our own thing. And let's say we wanted to mod how many actions the duct tape has. So we can go here, click before class, type modded space. Now we're modifying the class duct tape. And here we can go, oh, I wish to add, go add action. And then we can add in our own self-made action. So we'll call it action example A. Now, if I were to save this mod and boot it up with the proper things, I would be overwriting it. But let's say we didn't want to do any of that. Let's say we wanted to make our own class that inherits off of duct tape. So we could then go down and create our own class by going class duct tape underscore example, and then we can inherit off of duct tape. Now, what we could do here is, since we created our own class, we don't have to modify it. But what we can do is we can create our own thing. So go ahead and select the entire thing up here, copy, and then we go paste. Now, as you can see here, we have all these actions, but we don't need to do any of this stuff, so we can just delete it. But what we can do now is we can add in our own action, go add action, and we go action example register. Now, what will happen is since my duct tape inherits off of duct tape and duct tape inherits off of item base, I inherit all the actions off of item base and duct tape, plus this duct tape and this duct tape alone has that special action registered to it. Now, this works for, again, strings, bools, integers, and floats. All of these things are doable. Even the voids and the booleans are inside of it as well, or otherwise known as functions, true or false statements, and everything else. Most times, you're going to be working with the stuff and making and overriding already existing functions. But this is the stuff that I wished I knew when I first started modding in DayZ and understanding the concept of inheritance.